take a peek, guys?
Look at that naughtiness. Just getting some color on this stuff. And goes the peppers.
The jalapenos are now, I just put them in. Now it's getting this nice little soiree of party happening.
That onion's doing a little dance there. We like that. So making it happy.
Now let's get our oranges and our limes.
Our little wedges. I'm just going to squeeze some juices in there. I'm dropping it all in. Sorry. Whew. That was right at you, 3D.
So y'all see that orange and lime in there? Go ahead and add yours.
Smoky pork.
Smoky pork.
So I've, like I said, I pre-smoked my pork.
I'm going to add that right in here into this mix. With all those yum-yums. Now we're gonna add our OJ. Give it a nice little braising liquid party in there. I just got it lightly covered over half, retaining any extra orange juice if I need to add it later on, if we've burned off any. Little S&P, it's good for me. And then I'm going to put in a little crushed red because I like a little crushed red to ours. It brings the fun. All right, so at this point, the pork has been added. So we're just gonna let that continue to heat up. I'm gonna cover it. And then this is gonna go into your oven at 250 degrees, and it's gonna be going for about 5.5-6 hours before this is ready. In the meantime, step two of this process that we can get done right now and have some fun while this is heating up before I go into the actual oven, I'm going to start working our barbecue sauce. So we're going to make a from scratch barbecue sauce, but we're going to cheat it a little bit. What are you going to need? A little bit of ketchup, whatever your flavor is. Going to need a can of soda. This is 1.5 tablespoons of chili powder. You've got 1 teaspoon of smoked paprika, garlic. If you want to add any other essence like ginger or lemongrass, you can. 1/3 cup of brown sugar, and of course garlic, and then salt and pepper. So we're going to start that up. We'll get that oil hot. Let's see how we're looking here. Ooh, ah. It's going to be naughty. Yes, one forgot. A little Worcestershire, a little leaf greens, Worcestershire sauce. So that gives you a little bit of a little sultry, savory flavor in the background of it. So not everything's just completely tart. Or it's completely sweet as well. So I've already got some ginger. And we got some garlic. And I'm just going to take my garlic and I'm going to start doing a little choppy choppy dance on it. We've done this all before. You want to just mince this up pretty good?
Yeah, we did get
a little trick for y'all when you're mincing garlic. Get your kosher salt, put it on the board. It gives a little bit of traction, a little friction. So when you start using your knife to work it out and mince it up. Alright. So, got my nice minced garlic. Let's go do some sauce work. It's gonna go in there, into my saucepan. Once again, I do not want to just, I don't want to burn this garlic, so I'm doing under like a medium heat. I don't want it turning bitter, I just want enough, a little bit of, caramelization on there, just to start to get the party rocking. If you want to add jalapenos or any other kind of essence, like a ginger or whatever your flavor is, you can go right ahead and add it in here and saute it up. We can have a little bit of fun with that as well. But your sauce is your sauce. Make it yours. Have fun with it.
How much Worcestershire did you put in there?
I haven't added it yet. We're going to add it here once we add the... So we got to get through the basically caramelization of some of this stuff. We're doing off with any kind of garlic. And if you're going to add any essence, like I might add a little bit of jalapeno in here just to have a little bit of accent in the background. And then we're going to deglaze with the soda. So if you're using root beer, which is awesome... or if you're using Coca-Cola, Pepsi, whatever your flavor is, whatever your danger is. We're using it for the coloring, the sweetness, caramelization about it. So there's a lot that you can, use it to enhance it. I'm going to add a little bit of jalapeno in mine just because my family likes a little bit of heat. We can also add a little onion if you want. Always fun.
Did you already put your soda in?
Not yet. Not yet. We're deglaze. We gotta deglaze first.
Not yet.
So here's what it looks like. I've got a little bit of jalapeno, some garlic in there, a touch of onion, just for fun. Like I said, I had leftover ginger, so we're gonna have some fun with ginger in there as well. You don't have to do this, it's just an option. Just for another essence and flavor.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Couple steps that we're going to do before we get into this party. Just going to have to move my stuff on over. So you can just roll right through it. All the stuff is ready to rock. As you see here, we're starting to saute this up. It's looking good. I am going to add my chili powder. I'm going to let the heat basically release the oils in that powder. Let it get aromatic. Gonna add my smoky paprika in there. So as you see, it's almost turning out like a roux. I'm gonna add some brown sugar. So I'm getting this almost like a dry mix kind of working. And that's a third of a cup of brown sugar that I used. Someone building a car. Body work. Then comes your soda. You're gonna take your soda. We're gonna add it on in there. And I use probably about a quarter of a can. Not a whole lot. So I'm going to let this reduce down because right now it's really watery, and that's fine. I want to reduce it down. I want to intensify the sugars and turn this Coke into like a syrup, basically. And we're just going to let that get all bubbly and knotty. I'm now going to take my pork, and it's going to go into the oven.
All right, pork at what temperature?
250 degrees, and it's going to go in there for like 6 hours. That's fine. So, do you have your pork in a vessel, like some kind of vessel with all the sauce and everything?
Yeah.
All right. So take the whole vessel and put it on the smoker.
Okay.
And that way you can baste it as it goes. And then eventually you'll take it out of there and you can finish it up on the smoker as well, just by itself, once you get that flavor profile that you're looking for. So as you see, we're starting to reduce this down, which is good.
All right, reducing down a little bit?
Yep, we're just going to keep on letting it reduce down and have a little bit of fun, because eventually I'm going to add our ketchup, our Worcestershire sauce, and then we'll bring it down to a low flame and just let that just kind of mellow out and get nice and smooth, and let it caramelize over and give some color to it. And then we can add salt and pepper and add any kind of seasonings that we want as well. Ooh. I like doing this with root beer a lot too. Root beer is really good because it has vanilla in it, a lot of vanilla in it, and the cane sugar, which makes it taste really good. Thank you. So we're going to let this reduce down by half from what we had before, so intensify that sugar. Just so you guys can get yourself prepared for this afternoon. So this afternoon we are going to be doing basically the fabrication of said yumminess that we've got here, and we're going to do the slaw. So have your slaw mix, your oil, your vinegar, your vinegar, your mayo, any kind of seasonings that you want in there. I chose to do a little bit of Dijon, and what I'm using is a whole grain, large grain Dijon, just give a little bit of extra flavor to it. And we'll be making the slaw that goes with this, as well as the corn potato cakes that are going to be going with it. So if you have a grill at home or a smoker or whatever you're working with, go ahead and throw an ear on the grill and roast off that corn. I've already done it this morning. I roasted off, and then I had some time for it to cool, and then that way we can slice it down. We're going to use that inside our potato corn cakes, which will be really good. So that's the little homework that you guys are going to do until we meet later on this afternoon at 6 o'clock. And then we'll finish it all up, and it'll be pretty quick from there. So we're getting right about where I want it to be. I don't want it completely syrupy. I want to have a little bit of looseness to it because I'm going to be adding, you know, the ketchup in there. It's a little bit, using ketchup is an easier step just because instead of cooking tomatoes down and bringing it into a sauce and taking more hours to your day, ketchup's already got most of the work done. So you're going to use about 2 to 3 cups of ketchup into it. Yeah, 2 to 3 cups, and depending on, I mean, I'm doing a little bit larger group just because we go through a lot of barbecue sauce in this place. So now I got all my brown sugar in there. I've got all this works, and I'm going to just basically, I'm just going to bring this down to a low heat and let that continue to simmer. We can always taste and see where we're at as far as flavor profile. If you like it too tangy, like really tangy, you know, you can maybe add some citrus to it if you want a little bit more tangy to it. If you want more sweetness, you can always add more soda or even some more brown sugar. And also you can change your flavor profile as far as heat levels. So that is our sauce. We're going to let that cook down for about another 20-25 minutes on low, and then we're just going to go back through and make sure that whether or not we need to add salt and pepper or any other flavoring seasonings to get it to the level that we want for our pork this afternoon. Oh, and I did forget one thing. This is where the Worcestershire sauce comes in, right? So I'm going to do a few 3 to 4 dashes of Worcestershire in there. We're going to mix that up. And like I said, then we'll let it just cook on down and just on over a nice low heat.